Good morning, one and all. So let us start today's class. So in the last class, we were discussing about mean and variance of general random variable or continuous random variable. So what is the mean of a continuous random variable? That is integration minus 2 plus infinity x into fx of x dx. What is this? This is the PDF, probability density function. Now, so what about the variance formula could be? Before that, so variance of discrete random variable. What is the formula? Already we have discussed. What is the basic formula of variance? Suppose if x is a random variable, now it will be sigma x square that equal to expectation of x minus expectation of x whole square, isn't it? Now this can be written as summation over x. What do you write? X minus expectation of x whole square into px of x. What is this px of x? It is a PMF, probability mass function. Now, what could be the formula of variance of a continuous random variable? What do you do generally? Sigma x square equal to, then what do you write? This summation become integration x minus expectation of x whole square into, this is a PMF, it become PDF, fx of x dx. Now if you know the formula for discrete, you can simply write the formula for continuous. Now this is the variance of the continuous random variable. What is this? This is a PDF. Now this is the mean of the continuous random variable. This is the variance of the continuous random variable. Now, so in this formula, we have to write limits are from between minus 2 plus infinity. Here also minus 2 plus infinity. Just this summation becomes integration and the PMF becomes PDF. That's it. So if you know the formula for discrete random variable, you can easily write the formulas for continuous random variable just by doing two things. What are they? By changing summation to integration and PDF to PMF to PDF. Okay. Now, so this is one more way. Y equal to x plus b, where a and b are scalars. Then, so this already we have discussed. In case of discrete random variable, same thing is true for continuous random variable. Now, here what about variance? We know the variance formula in terms of moments. What is that? So variance formula in terms of moments, what is that? Expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. Now it is still valid for continuous random variables also. So this formula is valid for both continuous as well as discrete random variables. Okay. Now, so let us find mean and variance of a uniform random variable. First of all, what is uniform random variable? PDF. What is that? 1 by b minus a if x is between a and b, 0 otherwise. Okay. Now this is the PDF of a uniform random variable. We have discussed in the last classes. Okay. Now for this random variable, let us find its mean and variance. So what is the mean? Mu. I am writing simply mu. Mu x or mu. What is the formula? Minus 2 plus infinity x into fx of x dx. What is this? PDF. Now we know the PDF. From where to where? Okay, let me write here x into 1 by b minus a dx. But what about limits of integration? It is from where to where? A to b. A to b x by b minus a dx. But a and b are constants. So what will happen? 1 by b minus a integration a to b x dx. Then what do you get? So this is equal to 1 by b minus a into x square by 2 from a to b. Now next, so this is further equal to 1 by b minus a into b square minus a square by 2. Now if you do simple calculations, it is a plus b by 2, isn't it? You just try to calculate that and you will get the answer. That is a plus b by 2. Okay, next, what about the variance? So variance formula, simply sigma x square equal to expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. Already we know this, we have to find out the second moment. Okay, so let us find out the second moment. Now what is the formula of the second moment? So let me find the expectation of x square. That will be equal to integration minus 2 plus infinity x square into fx of x dx. Now this will be very very simple calculation. If you do so, you will get 1 by b minus a into x cube by 3, it is from a to b. Now it is something like b cube minus a cube by b minus a. If you do simplification, it would be simply equal to something is missing, 3, isn't it? Yeah, now it will be equal to simply, so a square plus b square plus ab over 3. But remember, this is second moment, that is not the variance. Now simply variance would be equal to second moment, that is a square plus b square plus ab by 3 minus mean square, isn't it? What is the mean? A plus b by 2 means a plus b whole square by 4. Is it okay? So if you do simple calculation, it will be equal to sigma x square will be equal to b minus a whole square by 12. So you do simple calculations, you do this calculation, you will get this b minus a whole square by 12. Okay. Right. So this is the mean and variance of a uniform random variable. What is the mean? A plus b by 2. What is the variance? B minus a whole square by 12. Now what is the mean and variance of exponential random variable? Mean and variance of a exponential random variable. First of all, what is the PDF of that exponential random variable? What is that? Lambda into e power minus lambda x if x is positive. It is 0 otherwise. Can you do this simple calculation? Okay. So, now what is the mean? Mean is from 0 to infinity. Why? Because it is from x equal to 0 to infinity. Okay. X into, what is the PDF? Lambda into e power minus lambda x dx. Isn't it? So we should do this calculation by parts. So what do you get? Integration by parts. What do you get? x into its differentiation. So e power minus lambda x, sorry, e power minus lambda x minus 0 to infinity plus integration 0 to infinity e power minus lambda x dx. So this will be 0. Now what is this? This will be simply 1 over lambda, 1 by lambda. Now, so that is a mean. What a variance? To find out variance, just now I told you, you must know expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. This is all just now calculated. So you just calculate the second moment. So what do you get? Expectation of x square formula would be integration 0 to infinity x square into lambda into e power minus lambda x dx. So integration by parts, what do you get? Minus x square into e power minus lambda x, it is 0 to infinity, plus what do you get? Integration 0 to infinity x square differentiation is 2x e power minus lambda x dx. Now if you do calculations, you will get this as, this will be 0 anyway. Now you will get 2 by lambda square. Now, so what is the variance formula would be finally? Sigma x square equal to 2 by lambda square minus mean square. What is the mean? 1 by lambda. So this will be equal to 1 by lambda square. This will be equal to 1 by lambda square. Now here, what is the mean of this exponential random variable? 1 by lambda. Variance 1 by lambda square. Now let us say, take a simple problem. So the time until a small meteorite means a piece of rock from space that has landed on Earth, first lands anywhere in the Sahara Desert, is modeled as an exponential random variable with a mean of 10 days. They gave you mean of what random variable? Exponential random variable. Means what? Mean equal to 10, which means 1 by lambda equal to 10 days. The time is currently midnight. So currently at 12 o'clock midnight. What is the probability that the meteorite first lands sometime between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. of the first day? Okay, they are asking. So what is the probability that the meteorite first lands sometime between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. of the first day? So let us read the problem one more time. The time until a small meteorite first lands anywhere in the Sahara Desert is modeled as an exponential random variable with a mean of 10 days. The time is currently midnight. What is the probability that the meteorite first lands sometime between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. of the first day? Now, so here they are modeling that as an exponential random variable with a mean 1 over lambda equal to 10 days, 10, which means lambda equal to 1 by 10. Okay. Now x is a exponential random variable. Now it is measured in days. What is x is? The time elapsed until the event of interest occurs. It is measured in days. Measured in days. Now, so what they are asking? what is the probability that meteorite will fall between anywhere between 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. Okay, now so here now currently the time is at 12 o'clock, midnight 12 o'clock. Now can I say something like this? So what is the probability that now I want to write in terms of days. Okay, 6 a.m. 12 o'clock is the current time, midnight 12 o'clock. What is 6 a.m. means? It is 1/4 of the day. Is it okay? So 6 a.m. means it is 1/4 of the day. Currently we are at 12 o'clock. 6 o'clock means we are at 1/4 of the day. 6 a.m. Let us take. Okay. Now less than equal to x less than equal to 6 p.m. means we are at 3/4 of the day. Why? Because x is the exponential random variable which is the time measured in days. Now just now I have just written 6 a.m. 6 p.m. as a days. 1/4 of the day, 3/4 of the day, because x is in days, not in hours. Okay, now we have to calculate this probability. So please make a note of this probability that 1/4 less than equal to x less than equal to 3/4. X is the exponential random variable with a mean 10 days, which means lambda equal to 1/10, because mean is 1/lambda. Now how to calculate this? We have something like this. This can be written as probability that x is greater than or equal to 1/4 minus probability that x is greater than or equal to 3/4. So these things we have discussed already. Okay, now so this can be written as like this. Please make a note of this. But so I told you in the last class is something like this. If x is a exponential random variable, what is the probability that x greater than or equal to a, what is that? E power minus a lambda. Do you remember this? Okay, so in the same way, what is the probability that x is greater than or equal to 1/4, what is that now? E power minus 1/40. Okay, so what is the probability that x is greater than 3/4? Obviously, what is that? E power minus 3/40. Do you remember this formula? Now finally the formula answer is 1/4 less than equal to x less than equal to 3/4 is equal to 3/4 is equal to e power minus 1/40 into e power minus 3/40. Okay, that is the final answer. You can do simplification if you want. Okay, now so we'll discuss something very very important. Okay, so we discuss one more type of random variable. That is called, we have discussed what type of random variables till now, uniform and exponential when it comes to continuous type random variables. Now so let us see what is this normal or also called as Gaussian random variable. Please remember this. So this is one of the most important random variables that we come across in our ECE. So wherever you go, you'll find this Gaussian random variable. Everything can be modeled as a Gaussian random variable. That is very, very, very important. So you must pay attention for this type of random variables. Okay. So this is one of the important random variables of our course. Now, a continuous random variable X is said to be normal or Gaussian. So it is known as Gaussian, or sometimes it is also called as normal random variable. Its PDF is something like this. You must remember this PDF. What is that? 1/σ into root 2π into e power minus x minus mu whole square by 2σ². Okay, so it has to be remembered. Okay, what is the PDF of a Gaussian or normal random variable? So sometimes I will write like this also, 1 by root 2 pi sigma square. Sometimes people will write like this also, okay, into e power minus x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square. Here, what is mu? Obviously, in this expression, mu is a mean, sigma square is a variance of normal random variable, where mu is a mean and sigma is a standard deviation. Obviously, sigma square would be variance. There are two scalars. Now, so it is also denoted as, so there is a special notation for this. X is said to be normal random variable with the parameters mu and sigma square. This is a notation to represent a normal or Gaussian random variable. So this notation is very, very important. Okay. So I have written here, this is very, very important. You must remember like this also. Sometimes they simply write like this, which means x is said to be a Gaussian or normal random variable with a mean mu and variance sigma square. Okay. Obviously, so the entire area under any PDF must be 1. So it has to be true. You prove this. Okay, try to prove this. What is this? Integration minus infinity to plus infinity fx of x dx. So here this is the PDF of our normal random variable. So it should be equal to 1. Okay, you prove this. Yeah, so one more thing is, this PDF is symmetric about its mean and it has a bell shaped curve. Very, very important. So there's something like this. Now this is the PDF. So it is having mu equal to 1. So that's why it is symmetric about its mean. You know what symmetry means. Okay. Now this is called bell shaped curve. So it is a bell shaped curve which is symmetric about its mean. And here it is having mean 1 and variance equal to how much? It is also equal to 1. So this is a curve of, this is a graph of PDF of normal or Gaussian random variable with a mean 1 and variance also 1. Now this is CDF. How to get CDF? If you integrate this, you will get this. It is by integration. Okay, we'll see later. Now this is the graph of PDF of a normal or Gaussian random variable having mean and variance equal to 1, which is called bell-shaped curve. And it is symmetric about its mean. So you can see very clearly here, here mean is 1 and it is symmetric about 1. So normality is preserved by linear transformation, which means, so if x is a normal random variable with mean mu and variance sigma square, and if a and b are scalars, then the random variable y equal to ax plus b is also normal with mean and variance equal to what? A mu plus b and a square into sigma square. So the important point is, if x is a Gaussian or normal, then y equal to ax plus b is also Gaussian. That's the meaning. So what it is called? This is called linear transformation. If you do linear transformation of any normal random variable, the resultant random variable is also normal. That is a point I want to make. Now what about the mean and variance of this y? Obviously we know mean is a mu plus b, variance equal to a square into sigma square. That is a different issue. But the only thing is, if x is normal, y is also normal. But what is y? It is a linear transformation of x, ax plus b. Okay? So this is very, very important. Make a note of this. If x is a normal random variable, y equal to ax plus b, then y is also normal random variable with a mean a mu plus b and variance equal to a square into sigma square. Now, here comes the point. We are discussing the standard normal random variable. So, here it is something like standardization. So, if I say standard Gaussian, or standard normal, what does it mean? Standard Gaussian or normal means a normal random variable with zero mean and unit variance is said to be standard normal. The term standard means here mean should be equal to 0 and variance should be equal to what? 1. So if you take any normal random variable whose mean is 0 and variance is unit or 1, then it becomes standard. It becomes standard form. Okay. Then what happens? So what is the PDF of standard normal variable? What is the PDF of normal random variable? Just now I have written 1 by root 2 pi sigma square e power x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square. If it is standard form, if it is in the standard form, what would happen? This mean would be 0, this variance would be equal to 1. Then this will be equal to 1 by 2 pi sigma square into e power minus x square by 2. Isn't it? Now this is a PDF of what form? Standard Gaussian random variable. This is a PDF of standard normal random variable or standard Gaussian random variable. Please make a note of this. This is very, very important. The term standard means mean should be equal to 0, variance should be equal to unity or 1. So obviously the notation is, so this is notation where mu is 0, variance equal to 1. Okay. Now these are the graphs of PDF and CDF of a standard normal random variable. Now you can clearly see its mean is 0. Okay. So that's why it is symmetric about mean. It is symmetric about 0 or origin. Now this is CDF. This is a PDF. Of what random variable? Standard normal random variable. Please make a note of this. If I say standard means, you must assume that its mean is 0 and variance equal to 1. Okay. Now, so how to make a random variable into a standard form? Suppose if x is a normal random variable with a mean mu and variance sigma square. Please, here x is a Gaussian or normal random variable with some mean mu and some variance sigma square. Here mu is not 0 and variance is not equal to 1. They are having some other values, let us take. We do standardization. How to make a random variable into standard form? So we define another random variable y that equal to x minus mu by sigma. So here y equal to x minus mu by sigma. Mu and sigma are scalars. They are constant because they are mean and standard deviations respectively. Now, what is y? It is a linear transformation of x. isn't it? So that's why just now I told you, if x is a normal random variable, y will be also equal to what? Normal random variable only. X is normal, then y is also normal. Now, what is the expectation of y? What it becomes? So, expectation of x minus mu by sigma. What is expectation of x? Mu. So, it is mu minus mu by sigma. This will be equal to 0. What is variance of y? Variance of x by sigma. Okay. This is sigma square. This is also equal to 1. Now, what happened here? Expectation of y is 0. Variance of y is 1, which means y is in what form? Standard form. Then y is a standard normal random variable. Okay. Here, suppose x is a normal random variable with mean mu and variance sigma square. Now I am defining another random variable y that equal to x minus mu by sigma. It is in this form only, y equal to ax plus b. That is a linear transformation. Compare these two. What is a? What is a? It is 1 by sigma. What is b? Minus mu by sigma. Can you compare these two? You can write this as x by sigma minus mu by sigma. So compare these two. What is x? What is a now? 1 by sigma. What is b? Mu by sigma. Now, so what is the mean of y? Just now I told you. A into mean of x. A mu plus b. Isn't it? So a mu. What is a? A is 1 by sigma. So it is mu by sigma. What is b? Minus mu by sigma. So it is 0 by sigma. That is 0. Isn't it? Now what is the variance of y? This is the expectation of y. What is variance of y? A square into sigma square. What is a square? 1 by sigma square. So this is sigma square by sigma square. That equal to 1. Here, so y is a, if x is a Gaussian or normal, y is also Gaussian normal. That is okay. But what happened here? Now I can simply say that y is normal random variable having mean 0 and variance 1. Then it is called in the standard form. Standard normal random variable. Okay, in this way we standardize the random variable, normal random variable. How? By a linear transformation, by writing y equal to x minus mu by sigma. You remember this point. This is a linear transformation which we use for standardizing the normal random variable. Standardizing means making mean 0 and variance 1. So that is the meaning of this expressions. Okay. Now CDF. So let us go to the CDF of the standard normal random variable. So please here, CDF means cumulative distribution function. I have told you last time also. That is very, very important. But here you must understand one thing. A normal random variable y with zero mean and unit variance is said to be a standard normal. Its CDF is denoted by y. Please remember, here we are writing CDF for what random variable? Standard normal random variable. Please make note of this. This is very, very important. Now its notation is phi. Generally, what is the notation of CDF? I told you, fx of x, isn't it? But we have a special case where we use this phi to write the CDF of what? CDF of what? Standard. I'm writing so many times. Standard normal random variable. It is not for normal random variable. It is a CDF of standard normal random variable. Please, please make a note of this. If you don't write the standard, things will be wrong. Okay. Anyway, now it is phi of y. You can also write phi y of y. That is also valid. Now, what is CDF definition? P y of y. Integration minus infinity to y fi of t dt. Now this is phi of y 1 by root 2 pi minus 2 y e power minus t square. This should be sigma e power minus t square by 2 dt here. So there is one important thing to be remembered, that is note that the table only provides the values of this CDF. Okay, otherwise, so this expression values can be found out from where? A table. So we cannot calculate each and every time. That's why there is a standard table. They'll give you the values in the, from the table itself. Okay, we calculate only for positive values of y because it is symmetric. I will tell you about this symmetry later. But so the values of this CDF can be obtained from a table. Okay, now this value, this integral value will be obtained from a table. Okay, so those things will be available to you in the form of a table. Is it okay? Now we will take one problem, so then you will get an idea. Now, so in the last, just now I told you a CDF, okay, let me write here, phi of y, how it is defined? 1 by sigma into root 2 pi integration minus 2 y e power minus t square by 2 dt, okay. Now you must know this, otherwise let me write here phi of y equal to 1 by sigma root 2 pi. So you can write this expression. Otherwise I think here the sigma is 1, no? And no need to write. If you write also okay, but it is one because we are doing standardization. You can write or you can omit this because it is one. Minus infinity to y e power minus t square by 2 dt. Now its values can be obtained from a table, standard table. Here you can omit this, no problem. Now, so here comes the important topic, that is a CDF of a normal random variable x with mean mu and variance sigma is obtained using the standard normal table. Now, so we are doing standardization in these steps only. You observe this very carefully. So what you can observe here is, so probability that x is less than equal to x, okay, so let me do this here. Otherwise you can directly do the normalization. Okay, Suppose they are asking probability that capital X is less than or equal to small x. Okay. Now what I do is I'll do subtraction on both sides. X minus mu less than or equal to, please make a note of this, small x minus mu. Okay. I am subtracting this mu on both sides of this inequality. Okay. Then what I do? I will do division by sigma on both sides. So there won't be any change in the inequality. Okay. Now what is this? It's called y, isn't it? So that equal to y is less than equal to x minus mu by sigma. Okay. Now, but what is y now? Y is a standard normal random variable. But what is x? X is a simply normal random variable. It is need not be in the standard form. Okay. Now, so yeah, here what is this formula equal to? Probability that, otherwise let me write here. Just now we have told that probability that y is less than equal to y equal to phi of y, isn't it? So let me go back here. Yeah. So phi of y equal to probability that capital Y is less than or equal to small y. So this is the definition of this CDF of the capital Y. Okay. Now, so let us observe the same definition here. Compare these two. Here, what is small y equal to now? X minus mu by sigma. Now, you can simply replace small y with what? Small x minus mu by sigma. Okay. In this way also, you can find out. So this is very, very important. So this is only one line equation, which is very, very important. Is it okay? So let us take a simple problem. The annual snowfall at a particular geographic location is modeled as a normal random variable. It did not say it is standard. It is simply a normal random variable with mean mu inches. Okay. Mu equal to 60. They gave you mean and standard deviation of 20. Sigma equal to 20. This is standard deviation, not variance. Okay. What the probability that this year's snowfall will be at least 8 inches? Now, so let us assume that x is a, okay, so read the problem properly, let us proceed for the solution. Okay, x is the annual snowfall. Okay, so x is modeled as a normal random variable. Now, so they gave you x is a normal random variable with mean how much? 20 and with a variance, not 20, 60, right? Sorry. 60 and variance 400 because standard deviation is 20. Okay. Now, so it is not in the standard form. This x is not in the standard form because to be in the standard form, you must have zero mean and unit variance. So here they are not 0 and 1. So it is not in the standard form. How to calculate this? Now what they are asking further? What they are asking? What is the probability that the snowfall will be more than 80? This is what they are asking. Okay. Now, so we should find out the standard form first. How to find standard form? Let us define another random variable y that equal to x minus mu by sigma. What is x? X is a normal random variable with mean 60 and standard deviation 20. Now what about y will be now? X minus mean is 60 by 20 is the standard deviation. X minus 60 by 20. Now, so what they are asking? Probability that x is greater than or equal to 80. Okay, then what do you do? So let us write this. Probability that x is greater than or equal to 80. Then what should I do? I should subtract how much? 60 on both sides. X minus 60 greater than or equal to 80 minus 60. And divide with what? 20. I am subtracting 60 and dividing with 20 on both sides. So then what will happen now? Probability that, now what is this equal to? X minus 60 by 20, just now we wrote 10. What is that? Y. But what is y? That is a standard normal random variable. Y greater than or equal to 20 by 20, that is 1. Okay. So let me write here. What is phi of y? Probability that capital Y is less than small y. Isn't it? Do you agree or not? So here what do you want? Y is greater than or equal to 1. How to write this? How to write this? This can be written as 1 minus probability that y is less than 1. Can you write like this? Okay. So what is probability that y is less than 1? That is phi of 1. Okay, so that's why probability that capital Y is greater than or equal to 1 will be same as 1 minus phi of 1. Now, what is this phi of 1? Please make a note of this. That is very, very important. What is this phi of 1? This is CDF of a standard normal random variable. So we have made it standard by doing some linear transformations. Now this phi of one value will be given in the table itself. They'll give you in the table. That is 0.8413. If you know this pi of 1, you can simply get this probability 1 minus 0.8413. You can calculate this. Okay, so let me recall the whole problem. X is the measure of the accumulation of snowfall in a particular area. It is modeled as a normal random variable. It is not in the standard form. It is having some mean, some variance, which is not equal to 0 and not equal to 1 respectively. Now they are asking what the probability that x is greater than or equal to 80. Okay, but we know you can make a normal random variable into standard form by using a linear transformation. What is that? Y equal to x minus mu by sigma. You know mu, you know sigma. Substitute here. Y equal to x minus 60 by 20. Now y will be standard normal random variable now, isn't it? Okay, now we want probability that x is greater than or equal to 80. So x minus 60, 80 minus 60, on both sides I have subtracted 60, after that I have divided with 20. Now what I got is this left hand side, this is nothing but y. it is nothing but 1. But so in CDF we should know, we have this values, probability that y is less than equal to small y. Now this can be written as 1 minus probability that y is less than 1. This is greater than 1. But what is this? This is a CDF from this formula. What is small y here? 1. This is pi of 1. So 1 minus pi of 1. This pi of 1 is what? CDF of a standard normal random variable, that is capital Y. Okay. As I told you, these values of this CDF can be obtained from a table. Okay, so that is 0.8413. Is it okay? So now we'll get the answer. So this is the standard normal PDF and standard normal CDF. Okay. Here mean is 0, variance is 1. It is symmetric about mean. Now this is values. What is this value? So let me write the standard normal PDF. What is that? 1 by root 2 pi e power minus x square by 2 per minus x square by 2. Okay. Now this is a standard normal CDF. So pi of 0.7 is 0.7. Sorry, this value will be given by the table. Okay. So we stop here. We'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.